lift your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the wisdom that is about to enter. Changes and transformation deep within their soul. We appreciate the words of wisdom they have heard right throughout this afternoon. I see futures aligning. I see scales falling from people's eyes. Let's pray for 30 seconds. That you as an individual will not miss out on the wisdom that is coming. 1, 2, 3, let's go. Even those watching on TV. Zaloka mahang, redigi destomo yundevert mas. Parujiko vehesa iantalemayas. Paruzin togehayas. Avrantelige stelke mente vertuva. I cobra duga destemente virus. Saluka mahan kredegodis. As your eyes are closed and you are praying, begin to see the next 40 years of your life lining up. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for great victory tonight. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. You can be seated in His presence. Thank you, Lord. It's good to see all of you. And those watching on TV. I understand that many of you have been here since 3 o'clock. We have our Sunday service tomorrow. But I want you to know that you must, to attend conferences and enjoy it, you must have a conference mentality. You come to a conference not just to be energized, but to be informed. So sometimes it can get boring if you're not careful. So those on watching on TV and those who are here today, I want to focus on, what did we look at yesterday? What did we look at? The prophetic timeline, right? At 12, at 30, at 70. The significance between these three stages. Today, I want to show you something that I've titled, within this prophetic timeline, there is something called prophetic cycles. Prophetic cycles. Now, don't imagine a bicycle. By cycle, I mean the completion of a process. Are you here? Now, for a mother to give birth to a child, what is the cycle?
9 months,
thank you. 9 months. Okay? A woman,
Striyak,
every month goes through a cycle. How many days? 28, thank you very much. 28 days. According to the Bible, temptation has a cycle. How many days?
Bible at anuwa parikshawanta chakrayak thiyena. Dawas kiyakda?
40 days.
Dawas 40ak.
That means,
ekenne,
at any given time in your life,
obe jeevithaye onam avasthawaka,
if you encounter the cycle of temptation,
oba parikshave chakrayakata athuluna nan,
it will last 40 days.
Eka dawas 40ak pavathiyevi.
So you will sense as though, my God, why am I going through what I'm going through? Why do I feel as though this is not stopping? Because it's only after 40 days that Matthew 4 and Luke 4 record that the devil left Jesus until the next cycle. You want to see it in your Bible? Why are you looking at me like that? It's in your Bible. Matthew chapter 4. Quickly, because of time.
Thank you, Lord. Take a look at Luke 4.
Luke chapter 4. Then the devil leaveth him. And behold, angels came and ministered to him. That's Matthew 4. You go to Luke chapter 4. It tells you something phenomenal. Luke chapter 4. Let's take a look at verse 13. And when the devil had ended all the temptation. What do you mean all the temptation? It's as though there's a cycle. And it lasted 40 days. It's a cycle. Yeah. It starts here and it ends here. So do in your prophetic timeline, it's wise to be mindful about what is called prophetic cycles. Take a look at Luke chapter 4 verse 13 again. He departed from him until the next cycle. That's what you mean by season. Another cycle. So this is why I call this prophetic cycle.
Are
you getting this? Now, prosperity also has a cycle. Looks like you don't want it, so we'll go to another subject. You know, prosperity has a cycle. The cycle is 3.5 years. That means if you decide now, by 2027
December,
you will be 10 times richer than what you are. I will prove it to you in the Bible. That all it takes for you to prosper is 3.5 years. It's the cycle of prosperity. Can I show it to you? Can I show it to you? Okay, to just show it to you, go to 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse number 4. We are focused on this age category, 30 to 70.
80. 90,
100.
See ya.
By reason of?
Strength.
Okay. Hello, my people.
Yes, sir.
Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is what I call the 40-year zone. In fact, in these next 45 minutes, I want to give you keys on how to protect yourself in these 40
years.
Look at you. I said, I'm giving you keys to protect yourself these 40 years. But before we go there, let me encourage you with this. It only takes you 3.5 years. That's 3.5 years. If you start today, what's the date today? 29th of June.
June 29.
By 2027. December
29th.
In these 3.5 years. Is my math right? In these 3.5 years. You can set your prosperity with a target and achieve it. Show it to you in the Bible. 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse number 4. David was 30 years of age.
30
years. Prophetic timeline. Are you here? 30 years of age. When he began to climb, he was ascending at 30. Life doesn't begin at 40. Life begins at
30.
Okay, your ascending starts at 30.
Obage nagima patanganna tihedi.
And if you didn't ascend, Still, the prophetic timeline is when you're 30, you start ascending. Now, if you're 40, and you feel you have missed out on 10 years, God in His grace and mercy will make some adjustments to catch up for lost time. By mercy, you'll catch up. It's called restoration. I will restore to you the years the locust has eaten. So be encouraged. So David started ascending at 30. And how many years did he reign? Come on, talk to me. How many years? So my question is, why 40? Because the cycle for climbing is 40 years.
Wow.
Prophetic cycles. My children, my people, my sons and daughters. God in His mercy. This is the reason why Israel spent 40 years in the wilderness. Why the blickety blickety blank blank was it 40 years? Why couldn't it be 41? Because it's a cycle, it's a prophetic cycle. So I declare to you, when you start climbing today, you will keep climbing for 40 years. I said you will keep climbing for 40 years. In the name of Jesus, I'm speaking. Those who believe will receive this grace. But you don't have to wait for 40 years. Because if you're 30, 40 means you're 70. To prosper. 3.5 years from the time you say yes, you can experience the completion of a cycle of prosperity. What do I mean by a cycle of prosperity? The completion of a dream. The fulfillment of an assignment. The completion of something that you know God told you to accomplish and you were able to accomplish. It only takes 3.5 years. This is why, take a look at the whiteboard. This is why Jesus started at 30 and in 3.5 years.
Wow. Clare ma kuse pentelebiostonam. Wow.
Why 3.5 years? Because 3.5 years is one cycle of prosperity. Are you not here? So I say again. If Mishu decides today, I'm going to do A, B, C, D, E, F, G starting today. By 2027, December
29th.
You will see the fullness of a dream. But just because I've said it, if it doesn't come to pass, it's just that you didn't do what you were supposed to do in this 3.5 years. You getting?
Yes, sir.
The cycle is in 9 months you had to have a child. But I'm not coming to supervise you in your bedroom. Verdi. You're getting it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
This is why David the king mirrors the ministry of Jesus. Take a look at the next verse. He began to reign for 40 years, David.
Oh, David,
but I want you to take a look at the next verse. My people, you are here, right? In Hebron, talking about David. In Hebron, he reigned over Judah 7 years and 6 months. Then the next part of the verse.
ඊට පස්සේ ඊළඟ කොටස කියනවා.
In Jerusalem.
Jerusalem-ේ
he reigned 30 and 3 years over all Israel and Judah.
ඔහු ඊශ්‍රායල් සහ යුදා කෙරෙහි අවුරුදු 33ක් රජකම් කළා.
Now do you know why Jesus had to mirror that?
ජේසුස් වහන්සේ මේ ඒකම ප්‍රතිරූපණය කරන්න
ඕනේ කියලා දන්නවද? Jesus is the son of David.
මොකද ජේසුස් වහන්සේ දාවිද්ගේ පුත්‍රයායි.
So his ministry
He
prepares for 30
years.
At 30 years, he understands a prophetic
timeline. And
in about 3 years and 3.5 years between that
period,
mirrors what King David went
through. And
Jesus finishes his
course.
It only takes 3.5 years.
Wow.
Let me give you another scripture if you are still not a believer.
James chapter 5
verse
17.
Prophetic
cycles.
Inside prophetic timeline.
Are
you listening, people? Let me go deeper. 15 more minutes and then we are going to minister. Elijah was a man with subject to like passions as we
are.
He prayed earnestly that it might not
rain.
And it rained not. Now take a look. It rained not by the space of 3.5 years.
Wow.
Elijah prayed. A prophet is praying. And he said,
okay, no.
It will not rain until I speak. And a cycle started.
චක්‍රයන පටන් ගත්තා.
My question to you.
මගේ ප්‍රශ්නේ තමයි.
When did the cycle end?
කවද්ද චක්‍රය අවසන් වුනේ?
3.5 years later.
අවුරුදු 3.5 මාරකට
පස්සේ. I'm trying to show you that 3.5 years is a cycle.
මම ඔබට පෙන්නන්නේ අවුරුදු 3.5 මාරක කියන්නේ චක්‍රයක් කියන එක. Wow, clearly master.
It rained after 3.5 years.
අවුරුදු 3.5 මාරකට පස්සේ වැස්සේ.
If you decide today.
ඔබ අද තීන්දු කළොත්.
By 2027 December 29.
2027 December 29 වෙද්දී.
It will rain like never before.
වෙන කවරදාකටද වහින්ට යනවා.
It's the prosperity cycle.
ඒ සඵලත්වයේ චක්‍රයයි.
I'm going to teach you what to do about it.
Are
you getting this? So for example, guys, if you start a business today, for goodness sakes, for goodness sakes, give the business 3.5 years. Because it's a thank you.
Chakrayak.
But only 10 of you are talking. Let me try this side. Because it's a what?
Mukaddeka?
If you get chakrayak married today,
oba,
give your marriage at least.
Oba thank you.
Thank you. Why?
Aye?
Because it's a cycle.
Mukaddeka chakrayak.
You're getting it now. Now that you know it's going to take 3.5 years, then you can put a plan. The problem why many of the young adults get discouraged because nobody informed you about cycles. Listen, when Jesus is talking about agriculture, he talks about the seed. When a seed hits the soil, he uses the corn as the example.
Okay?
Corn. He says, first, the blade, then the ear, after that, the full corn.
Karale sampurna kama.
3 stages.
Adiyar tunak.
It's like 3 years.
Eken avurudu tunak wage.
This is only an example. So Jesus explained how the seed grows.
Jesus wants pehadili karna bije vardhane wenna vidiya.
Stages.
Adiyara vishe
vadiya. When you plant a seed,
bija kitewona.
First the blade.
Mulimma kolayak kenawa.
Then the ear.
Ida passe karalak kenawa.
After that.
Ida passe
the full corn.
Karala sampurna kamenawa.
If you start a business,
oba vyaparayak patan gattot,
first
mulimma,
then
ita passe,
after that
ita pasuwa.
If you invest money,
oba mudal aayojana karot,
first
mulimma,
then
in anaturuwa,
after that
ita passe.
If you get married,
oba vivaha unoth,
first
mulimma,
then
ita passe,
after that
anaturuwa.
But the mistake you are making,
namuth oba karana waradda tamai,
you start a business,
oba vyapara patan gannawa,
after that
ඊට පස්සේ ඒක අවසානේ වල්ලා
කැලීම මෙතනට යනවා Make a fast food nemei. Make a Maggie soup nemei. Make a process ekak thiyeno.
Man.
God is not the inventor of the pyramid scheme.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේ පිරමීඩ් ස්කීම් එකේ ස්වාගත කෙනා නෙමෙයි.
There is no quick way to make money.
මුදල් හම්බ කරන ඉක්මන් විදි කියලා දෙයක් නැහැ.
If you find a way.
ඔබ එහෙම ක්‍රමයක් හම්බුනොත්
please
කරුණාකරලා
I'd like to meet you after the service.
දෙවියන් මෙන් පස්සේ මම ඔබ මුණ ගැහෙන්න කැමතියි.
There is no such way.
එහෙම ක්‍රමයක් නැහැ.
If you get money the easy way.
ඔබ ලේසියෙන් මුදල් හම්බ කරොත්
it will fly away.
ඒක නිකන් හුලඟට යයි.
There is a system.
ක්‍රමවේදයක්
තියෙනවා. There is a psychology.
ඒකේ මනෝවිද්‍යාවක් තියෙනවා.
There is labor involved.
ඒකට ශ්‍රමය අදාළයි.
But I see you getting this. There is a prosperity cycle.
චක්‍රයක් තියෙනවා සඵලත්වයට.
I say it again and again.
මම නැවත නැවත කියනවා.
It only takes 3.5 years.
අවුරුදු 3.5ක් විතරයි අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ.
This is why Jesus was a cool cucumber.
මේ නිසා තමයි ජේසුස් වහන්සේ බොහොම සැහැල්ලුවෙන් හිටියේ.
Till 30 his mother and father must be wondering, what are you doing? We thought you are the son of God. Go and do it quickly.
දේව පුත්‍රයා කියලා මොනවද කරන්න ගිහලා සේවය කරන්නකො.
This is why Mary pushed him to turn water into wine.
මේ නිසා ජේසුස් වහන්සේ මරියාව තල්ලු කරේ උන්වහන්සේව වතුර බෙදලා.
We haven't seen anything for 30 years.
අවුරුදු 30ක් කිසිම දෙයක් දැක්කේ නැහැ.
මොනාරි කරන්නකො.
Yes.
Jesus never was in a hurry.
Jesus wants kisi kalabalayak thibunna.
He knew cycles.
E aluth chakraya.
If I start now I only need 3.5 years.
Mama dan patan gattot avurudu 3.5 ay one.
He in fact said something similar.
Unwanse ebe samana deyak kiywa.
He said you can destroy this temple and in 3 days I'll rebuild it.
Oba me maligawa vinasa karoth ema dawas 3 kin mama
medunna. So whenever Jesus was speaking he's always using 3 3 3 3 3.
Jesus wanse katha karana hama thanama unwanse 3 3 3 3 pilibanda katha kala.
It's a prophetic symbolism.
ඒක ප්‍රපේතමය සංකේතයක්.
Let me know if I'm helpful to anyone.
අපට උදව්වක් නේද මේක?
Prophetic cycle.
ප්‍රපේතමය චක්‍රයන්.
Now, one of my sons is building a hotel.
මගේ පුත්‍රයෙක් මෙතන හෝටලයක් ගොඩනගනවා.
After the hotel is here it's opening on the 12th of September.
September 12 වෙනිදා ඒක විවෘත කරනවා.
Now watch.
දැන් බලන්න.
If he is wise.
එයා ඥානවන්ත නම්
he will have these 3 stages.
එයා මෙන්න මේ අධිවර තුන තියන්ට යනවා.
First.
මුලින්ම.
Then.
ඊළඟට.
After that.
ඊට පස්ව.
Anything should be divided like this.
ඕනම දෙයක් මේ විදිහට බෙදන්න ඕනේ.
You getting it?
වැටෙනව නේද ඒක?
Heshan said something nice.
Heshan ලස්සන දෙයක් කිව්වා.
He said your latter will be greater than your beginning.
ඔබගේ අවසානය ඔබගේ ආරම්භයට වඩා
වටිනවා. That's so prophetic.
ඒක හරි ප්‍රපේතමයයි.
Why?
ඇයි?
Because
මොකද?
When you start the process of 3.5 years.
ඔබ අවුරුදු 3.5 මාර්ග ක්‍රියාවලිය පටන් ගත්තාම.
Watch Jesus.
බලන්න ජේසුස් වහන්සේ.
He started by turning water into wine.
උන්වහන්සේ වතුර වයින් බවට පත් කළ පටන් ගත්තේ
මොකද? But as the 3.5 years ended.
අවුරුදු 3.5 ඉවරනකොට.
He's not turning water into anything.
උන්වහන්සේ වතුර මොනවත් කරන්න යන්නේ නැහැ.
He's walking on water.
උන්වහන්සේ වතුර උඩින් ඇවිදිනවා.
So it's like you graduate in the things you started.
ඒ කියන්නේ ඔබ පටන් ගත්ත දේවල් තුලින් ඔබ ඉහළට යනවා වගේ.
3.5 years is
all it takes. අවුරුදු 3.5ක් විතරයි අවශ්‍ය.
For you to do what God has called you to do.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේ ඔබ කැඳ උපදේ කරන පිණිස.
It's a cycle.
ඒක චක්‍රය.
So I call you to take the business to the next level.
ඒ නිසා මං කියන ඔබේ ව්‍යාපාරය ඊළඟ මට්ටමට
තරණය. Take your family to the next level.
ඔබගේ පවුල ඊළඟ මට්ටමට
තරණය. Have a 3.5 year plan.
අවුරුදු 3.5ක සලස්මක් හදන්න.
Aim at it and start today.
ඒක ඉලක්ක කරලා අද පටන් ගන්න.
Don't get discouraged along the way.
යන ගමන් අධෛර්යමත් වෙන්න එපා.
අයියෝ මොනක්වත් වෙන්නේ නැ නෝ. Go and have meeting after meeting after meeting. Go and invest time with the business. Go and do what you have to do.
කලයට දේ කරන්න.
Build the brand.
ඒ සන්නාමය ගොඩ
නගන්න. Meet the right people.
හරි පුද්ගලයන් මුණ ගැහෙන්න.
Sometimes you'll meet somebody today and you'll wonder next month nothing is coming out of the relationship. Give it 3.5 years.
සමහර අද කෙනෙක් හම්බෙලා ඊටස මුකුත් වෙන්නේ නැහැ කියලා හිතයි ටික කාලයක් ඇදී අවුරුදු 3.5ක් දිලා බලන්න.
So barat to kiyade fiento varas. Are you getting this?
අපිට වැටෙනවද මේක?
Can I go deeper in this?
ගැඹුරට යනවද මම මේකේ?
Okay. Now let's forget about the 3.5 years.
දැන් අවුරුදු 3.5 අමතක කරමු.
Let's focus on the 40 years.
අපි අවුරුදු 40 ගැන අවධානය යොමු
කරමු. Because tomorrow I'm not going to talk about this.
මොකද මේ ගැන ආයෙ මම හෙට කතා කරන්න යන්නේ.
Tomorrow I want to give you 7 keys on how to be a rock solid role model.
ඊටාත්ම ප්‍රබල ආදර්ශකයෙක් වීම සඳහා අවශ්‍ය යතුරු
හතක් දෙන්න යනවා. We want to focus on the 40 years now.
අද අවුරුදු 40 ගැනයි දැන් අවධානය යොමු කරන්න යන්නේ.
Yeah, thank you Dimi. Can you erase the whole thing? How about those watching us on TV? We need a system where I can hear them say something. But I'm sure they're saying something.
TV වල නෑ මොනාර කියනව නේද?
Say something. Say something. Words of Bob Marley. 40-year period.
අවුරුදු 40ක කාල පරිච්ඡේදය.
The 40-year zone.
අවුරුදු 40ක කාල කලාපය.
From 30 to
70.
Such an important phrase or phase in our lives.
You're here? Psalm 90,
verse number 10. When we say 30 to 70, we are in no way trying to refer that your life ends here. No, that's why I put plus, 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 plus. Okay, Psalm 90, verse number 10. Come, let's look at it. 15 more minutes. Are we learning? Okay. The days of our years are 80 years and 10. And if by reason of strength, they shall be 80 years. By reason of strength.
Shakti.
That word strength there means force. It's the same word for that is used to describe Deuteronomy chapter 34, verse number 7. Not the identical word, but similar. It means force. It means strength. It means another beautiful Hebrew word. It means freshness.
Freshness.
When you go to a supermarket and you want to buy vegetables, you look for freshness. So Deuteronomy 34, verse number 7, please. It describes
Moses
at the age of 120, like this. Moses was 120 years when he died. His eye was not dim, nor his natural force abated. That word force there is similar to the word strength in Psalm 90, verse
10.
I believe you are listening. It means freshness. So the Bible is giving us a secret to long life. When you get to 70, if you have taken care of yourself during these 40 years, you will have freshness to continue. You won't have knee pains. You won't have cataract in your eyes. You won't have bum problems. You won't have headaches. You look good. I want to give you the secrets on what to do in these 40 years. Not tomorrow. Now.
Other than.
Now.
Then.
If I were you, I'll take it. I won't take it and leave it. I'll take it and eat it. I'll take it with all my might. These 40 years, they are vital for us. If you don't give up, God's grace will work for you. Here are some keys. Depending on your attention span, I'll give you 5. If your attention span is good, I'll give you 7.
30
to 70. Here's how I plan it out. If you're 30, I would encourage you to have a 10-year plan. If you're 40, same. If you're 50, same. If you're 60, the same. It's easy to plan every 10 years. Are you getting it? It's wise. Now you should know that I'm hinting at something. What am I hinting at? That 10 years is also a cycle. 10 in Hebrew means nothing missing.
Hebrew වලින් 10 කියන එක අදහස් තමයි කිසි අඩුවක් නැහැ කියන එක.
There's nothing missing.
කිසි අඩුවක් නැහැ.
That's why God gave Israel how many commandments?
ඒ නිසා තමයි ඊශ්‍රායෙල් දෙවියන් වහන්සේ ආඥා කීයක් දුන්නද?
Why wasn't it 11?
ඇයි 11ක් නොදුන්නේ?
Why wasn't it 9?
ඇයි 9ක් නොදුන්නේ?
Why is it 10?
ඇයි 10ක් දුන්නේ?
It's because it's a cycle.
I hope
you're learning. So I would plan for every 10 years. And here's the key. What you do Between 30 and 40 will determine how you enjoy 40 to
50.
When you get to 40 and 50, it's too late. If you want to enjoy something here, you have to start here. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Within Navashana, Addakaga Navashana, Metanatama Aramagran.
Yes, sir.
Ogorikino compound effect. What you do here across 10 years has a compound effect.
Oba Metana Karna deeta, Eka Matupita Inama, Balapamak, out of the Hayakan.
Hearing it? Okay. What you do between 40 and 50
Hatalia Panayatra Bakarna de
will give you pleasure during 50 and 60. What you do during 50 and 60 will give you pleasure during 60 and 70. If you want something here, you have to start here.
Nahayen
obba podda balannone. Very important. So here are some things to follow. Number one, if you want to enjoy this 40 year zone, as you grow older in age, there is a possibility to grow in freshness. That's why when people meet us, I was walking the other day, I walk every day, even now I'm walking. I realized I have a 19-year-old daughter now. We take a step back and look at ourselves in the mirror and say, you have a 19-year-old daughter. It's crazy. Because to me, I don't care about what you think, to me, it doesn't look like I have a
19-year-old.
So the secret is what I want to show you. Because if you want to maintain freshness, there are things you can do. Number one, Paul the Apostle calls it temperance. Now these words might sound boring, but they are the most powerful words. Temperance. He brings it up in 1 Corinthians chapter
9.
Verse number 25. It talks about temperance. What is temperance? Temperance is the ability to cut back. If you want to be an athlete, that's the idea. If you want to be an athlete, you want to be like
Usain Bolt.
You can't eat ice cream like Subodha. I did something funny recently. I went to his office. I got into the vehicle. I was driving off. I said, Subodha, come
here.
Come close. And I squeezed his belly fat like this. I said, yeah, ice cream. Because I was in his boardroom. Let me show you a photograph. Can I show it to them? Not you, man. I'm asking him. Subodha, can I show them that picture? Man, you put that delete timer or something like that on purpose. All right. Yeah. Madhu, can you project it? I want you to take a look at this picture. I'm in the boardroom. I'm actually having a business meeting, not a church meeting. I'm having a business meeting. And while I'm having that meeting, I'm looking and I can see Subodha in his office. I want you to notice what's on his right hand side. As you know, Madhu is the one who is projecting it, so she's going to take her time with this. She's right now praying that that thing will become invisible in the picture. It'll come in a moment, trust me. Stretch your hands towards the screen. It's because Subodh is rebuking this right now. It's right in the name of Jesus. I want you to notice what's on the right side of the table. The healthy packets of tea or samhan there is just a decoy. It's just a just a deterrent or whatever you call it. It's just what you see there is the Kandos chocolate wrapper, that whatever 300-gram slab that he has just finished eating all by himself while I'm in the boardroom.
මම බෝඩ්රූම් එකේ ඉඳදී ආ තනියම කාපු කැන්ඩෝස් චොක්ලට් එක ග්‍රෑම් 300ක චොක්ලට් එක කවරේ
තමයි තියෙන්නේ. I say this even though it's funny.
විනෝදයක් වුණත් මම ඒකට කියන්න ඔබට.
Temperate means
මේ temperate කියන වචනේ අදහස් තමයි.
Where Paul is referring to it in 1 Corinthians 9:25.
පාවල් තුමා කතා කරනවා පළවෙනි 9:25 අපි කියවමු.
He says every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things.
දින දිරන් අටුන්නක් ලබා ගන්න හැමෝම හැම දෙයකම
Put some energy to what you're saying. I know you must be tired.
No, it's the word isn't.
Temperate means you cut back.
ඔබ ටිකක් පල්ලයට තල්ලු කරගන්නත් අඩු කරගන්නවා වගේ දෙයක්.
Cut back.
අඩු කරගන්නවා.
And by the way, I'm watching the service from the time it started.
පටන් ගත්තලෙන්ද මම දේව මෙහෙම බලනවා.
As young adults, your energy levels are like පුස් වෙඩිල්ල.
තරුණ වැඩිහිටියන් විතර ඔබගේ ශක්තිමත්
බව. I conduct services for 8 hours. You can't tell me about energy. ජීවිතේදී
ඔබ සාර්ථක වෙන්න අවශ්‍ය නම් යම්කිසි
Let's look at it again. Every man that wants to be a champion, that's what Paul is saying.
සූරෙක් වෙන්න අවශ්‍ය හැම කෙනෙක්ම.
You must cut back.
ඔබ ඒක යමක් පස්සට තාත්
කරනවා. As you grow older,
ඔබ වයසට යන අතර
watch the whiteboard.
බලන්න whiteboard එක දිහා.
From 30 to 40,
30 ඉඳලා 40 දක්වා
whatever you accommodated.
ඔබ ඒකට යොදවන ඕනම දෙයක්.
You have to cut back from 50 to 60.
අවුරුදු 50 60 වෙද්දී ඒක අඩු කරගන්නවා.
You can't eat a whole slab of chocolate the way he was eating it.
Oh, ek apu aakarata mulu chocolate ekak ma kanna baha.
I don't know if you're getting this.
Atanada padana eka.
If you continue like that,
oba e vidiyata digata giyo,
that's the opposite of temperance.
Eka villa temperance kenakata viruddha patta renawa.
It's called temperadu. You'll be done.
E munata oba ivarai.
So one of the virtues to enjoy these 40 years is temperate.
මේ අවුරුදු 40 හොඳින් විඳින්නට නම් ඒ විදිහට ඔබ වළක්වා ගන්න සිද්ධ වෙනවා.
Focus on cutting back on certain things.
යම් යම් දේවල් අඩු කරගෙන පිනන අවධානය යොමු
කරන්න. Don't overdo anything.
කිසිවක් ඕන්ට වැඩිය කරන්න එපා.
Don't go to the gym 7 days of the week.
දවස් 7ක් gym එකට යන්න එපා.
Don't eat 3 meals a day.
දවසට කෑමවල 3ක් කන්න එපා.
Don't even if you're married you can't live on sex.
ඔබට විවාහ වෙලා සිටියත් ඔබට ලිංගික ක්‍රියා මතම ජීවත් වෙන්න බෑ.
Give it a break.
ඒකට විරාමයක් දෙන්න.
Or give that a break.
ekada viramayak denna.
Oh wacana maga harino. Ekada viramayak denna. Mokada viramayak? Ekada viramayak denna.
Yes sir.
No really because
mokada
That's how you train yourself to be temperate.
E vidiyata thamai oba walakwa ganeema gana poonu karanne.
Of course some of you are generals in this you're too temperate.
Oba gen samahara mekata
own wediya walakwa. Your wife hasn't seen you in 2 months.
Baharya oba dakala ne maasa dehekin.
So after 2 months when you're getting ready she won't even recognize that or you.
Oba last wenakota aya ekawat obawat handuna ganne ha.
And men
පුරුෂයනි
ප්ලීස්
කරුණාකරලා
as you this is for married people
මේ විවාහක අයට
your sex life
ඔබගේ ලිංගික ජීවිතය
has to become more interesting as age goes by
වයස වැඩි වෙන තරමට වඩා ආකර්ෂණීය වෙන්න ඕන
if it's not
එහෙම නැවේ නම්
you need deliverance
ඔබට නිදහස් වීමක් අවශ්‍යයි yes sir
come the silence silent
okkomarini anai
is the truth
ekama atta
Marriage is like good wine.
විවාහය හරියට යහ හොඳ මුද්‍රික පානය වගේ.
The older it gets, the stronger it gets and the better it gets.
පරණ වෙන තරමට ඒක ශක්තිමත් වෙනවා, වඩා යහපත් වෙනවා.
Sex,
ලිංගික ක්‍රියාවන්.
In marriage you have to have good sex.
විවාහය තුළ ඔබ හොඳ ලිංගික ක්‍රියාවන්ට යොමු වෙන්න ඕනේ.
Men get into moods because of this thing not being done properly.
පුරුෂයෝ මේ කාර්ය හරියට නොකරන නිසා තමන්ගෙම
චිත්තවැගන්තෙනවා.
කාන්තාවන් බොහොම නිහඬව දුක් විඳිනවා කළ යුතු දේ නොකළ යුතු දේ කවුරුත් උගන්වන්න
නිසා.
ඔබ හිතන එක අවශ්‍ය නැහැ කියලා.
Let me put a breaking news out there.
මම breaking news එකක් ඔබට කියන්නම්.
Those watching on TV.
TV බලන අයත්.
Everyone is not Anna the prophetess.
හැමෝම Anna දිවසිවරිය නෙමෙයි.
You know another prophetess?
Anna Divasivariya?
After marriage, the husband died 7 years after marriage.
අවුරුදු 7කට පස්සේ.
It's in the Bible.
බයිබලෙ තිබෙනවා.
But after the husband died,
ස්වාමිපුරුෂයා මියගියාට
පස්සේ, she didn't remarry.
ඇය නැවත විවාහ වුණේ නැහැ.
There was a gentleman asking a question about how his wife died and what's my purpose, etc.
මාත්මේ ප්‍රශ්නයක් අහුවා, භාර්යාව මැරුණා මගේ අරමුණ මොකද්ද ඒ වගේ දේට.
Anna the prophetess said marriage is not for me, my focus is going to be I'm going to be in the temple of God.
Anna devasivariya kiwa mage vivahayak neha mama deva maligawen
yanawa. And her intercession ushered the messiah into Jerusalem.
Ayage madihatkama osse Jerusalemata the messiah wahansege pæminima siduna.
You getting this?
Matana dabar meka.
And yet she got married, so that means she was okay with other thing.
Etta vivaha una kene adahas thama ayage anith karyan sampurna thula thibuna
kene. But she was disciplined enough to say now I don't need marriage.
Namuth ayata vinayak thibuna dan mata vivaha
yanna kiyala kiyanne. But if you're married you can't become another prophetess.
Namuth oba vivaha vela innawa nan obata ana divasivari wage wenna baha.
Divasivari wage wenna baha.
Yes.
Husband eno oyaagna kamare thano.
Sondala barabara shakaraba shikaraba sokaraba chikaraba.
Husband athana
ha barabara barabara barabara. ස්වාමී මගේ බර බර තා කාටවත් තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ. හා මගේ බර කාටවත් තේරෙන්නේ
නැහැ. No one understands my bara bara. You see, in marriage you don't have to have sex every day.
විවාහය තුල හැමදාම ලිංගික ක්‍රියා අවශ්‍ය නැහැ.
Cut back.
එක වලක්ව ගන්න ටික.
Don't jump on each other every day.
හැමදාම එතට යමු එපා.
It's called being temperate.
ඒක අදහස් කරන්නේ කම් වලක්වා ගැනීම වගේ දෙයක්.
Keep the spice in the rice.
Shiran, why are you blushing?
මුළු සර්විස් එක මම දැක්කනේ යාගේ දිව මෙතන එළව. දිව එනවා එළියට.
මොකද වෙන්නේ?
VP is annoying you. I'm coming after the first row tonight.
Mam palaweni peliya passen enawada?
Can I go deeper?
Gamburata yanada ma?
Of course in a subject like this.
Me wage vishayaka.
You just want us to go deeper. You're forgetting children are watching on TV, YouTube. Glorious TV. So temperate means
emanage walakwa ganima kiyana
adahas karana. You cut back here so you
oba metana walaka
ganna. Enjoy here.
Etana bukti vindina pinisa.
Hmm? Getting it?
Therunada?
Number 2.
Deweniyaka.
As you are growing in this 40-year time zone,
ඔබ මේ අවුරුදු 40 කලාපය තුළ වර්ධනය වෙන අතර
focus on relevance.
මේ අදාළත්වය ගැන අවධානය යොමු කරන්න.
Relevance.
අදාළත්වය.
Relevance is a power word.
අදාළත්වය කියන්නේ
බලවත් වචනයක්.
බලවත්.
Relevance.
අදාළත්වය.
Now what happens to a lot of people who grow in these 40 years, you're listening right?
මේ අවුරුදු 40 වර්ධනය වෙන බොහෝ අයට වෙන දෙයක් තමයි.
In this 40 year time period,
මේ අවුරුදු 40 කාල රේඛාව තුළ
they become totally irrelevant.
ඒ අය සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම අදාළ නැති කෙනෙක් බවට පත් වෙනවා.
අවුරුදු 50කට ඉස්සෙල්ලා ගාපු sunlight එක තාම ගන්නවා. Just as an example. You're irrelevant.
ඒ මොනත් ඔබ අදාළ නැහැ.
So now your daughter is getting married or your son is getting married.
Dan duwa natta puta vivaha wenawa.
You're looking for a car. EL1011.
EL 1011.
There is a reason why Jesus turned water into wine.
Jesus vanse vathura mudduka paane karanna hetuwak thibba.
Because in that wedding, that's what they want.
Mokade mangala utsave eka thama awashya une.
So to be relevant, Jesus has to give the people what they want.
Adala wenna manushyanta awashya de Jesus vansara denna siduna.
Most people, as they grow older in age, they lose their relevance.
Boho aya vayasata yana tarama tamange adalatwe adu karagannawa.
So they come to 60 years.
Avurudu 60 wenakota.
And they tell the children, api neme ohoma kare.
Daruwanta kena api ohoma kare naha kiya.
Then the children say, api tamai hondanama kare. Are you getting this?
Therana neda?
Irrelevant. This is where parents clash with children.
Adala noy manisa tama daruwa dema ape samaga gatenne.
Children say, my parents. Is complain is what?
Daruwema chodana karanne ai.
We don't understand our parents.
Ape demopiyan apata
kata ganna. Parents don't understand.
Ape demopiyan apiyo therennet naha.
It is one of the challenges in this 40 year period to maintain your relevance.
Me avurudu 40 obage adalatwe oba nadattu karagena
yanawa. How do you maintain relevance?
Oba kohomada meka nadattu karagena yanne?
You have to read.
Oba kiyawanna one.
You need fresh information.
Obata alut toraturu one.
You need to walk with people who are up to date with what's happening in the world.
Loke deval samaga yavat kalena vechcha manushya ekka oba gaman karanna one.
Am I helping anybody?
Udaw karanada kaata hari?
So we need that.
Apata eka awashyay.
Relevance.
E adalatwe.
Jesus said you don't put new wine into old bottles.
Jesus,
why? Irrelevant.
Alut mudrika paane parana sambhajana wala daanna eken adala
ne. That's irrelevance.
Etana nogalapimak thiyena.
We need relevance.
Apada adalatwe awashya.
So in this 40 year period,
me avurudu 40 kaala thula
update yourself with new information.
Alut toraturuyin yavat kaalena wenna.
What's happening in the world?
Loke monada wenne?
How many of you watched the Joe Biden and Donald Trump debate?
Joe Biden Donald Trump vivade kawuda baluwe?
How many of you?
ඔබෙන් කීයද බලවද?
Just 5 of you.
5 දෙනෙක් විතරයි.
නෑ අපි ඇමරිකාවේ නෙමෙයිනේ ප්‍රොෆෙට්. හලෝ. අපි ඇමරිකාවේ ණය ගත්ත රටක්. ඇමරිකාවේ වෙන දේවල් අපි දැනගෙන ඉන්න ඕනේ. You must know what's happening.
දැනගන්න ඕන මොකක්ද සිද්ධ වෙන්නේ කියලා.
Be relevant.
අදාළ වෙන්න.
The reason why you could be 35 and you still don't have a boyfriend.
ඔබ 35ක් වයස් වෙලාත් පෙම්මතෙක් නැති
වෙන්න හේතුව. Or you're 38 and you don't have a girlfriend.
38 වෙලාත් ගැහණු ළමයෙක් නැති වෙන්න හේතුව.
Is because you're dressing like the 1940s.
මොකද 1940 ගණන් වල වගේ තමයි බඳින්නේ.
This is a young adults conference. If you brought your little children.
ඔබ තරුණ වැඩිහිටි සමුළුවක් පුංචි දරුවෝ ගෙනාව නම් මට වග කියන්න බෑ.
Okay. No children, right?
දරුවෝ නැහැ.
Okay. Let's go offline for 5 minutes.
අපි මිනිත්තු 5කට
just kidding. Relax. Let them be. It's up to you. Listen, relevance means.
අදාළත්වය කියලා කියන්නේ.
Pastor, close your ears please. Relevance means.
අදාළත්වය කියන්නේ.
After 20 years of marriage.
අවුරුදු 20ක් විවාහ වෙලා හිටියට පස්සේ.
Your husband shouldn't be telling you what he likes in the bedroom.
ස්වාම පුරුෂයා ඔබට කියන්න ඕනේ නැහැ එතකොට මොකද්ද ඔහු කැමති වෙන්නේ කියලා නිදන කාමරයේදී.
අවුරුදු 20කින් පස්සේ වා තේරුම් ගන්න ඕනේ මූටාසන් කියලා. In English.
After 20 years you have to understand that he is Tarzan.
Ha 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 ha. So what does Tarzan like?
Tarzan mona wageida?
He wants Jane to come hanging on a chandelier.
Chandelier ke lila innona.
Now if you are Jane,
oba Jane na
and wise,
ñanamantawa,
you will say I need to be relevant.
Oba kiyanna ne mama adala kenek bawata pat wenna ona kiyala.
You don't tell your husband, no, you have to love me as I am.
Swampurchara kiyanne epa mam me inna widiyata mata aadare karanna kiya.
What about relevance?
Adalatte gena mokak?
What about growing old?
Me vayasata yama vardhane wima kene mokak dena?
You can't be wearing here what you if you wore senorita here.
Oba metana senorita andot ema.
You have to wear Victoria's Secret here.
Metana Victoria's Secret andinna ona.
Victoria's Secret is most needed here.
Victoria Secret වැඩියම අවශ්‍ය වන්නේ අතනයි.
Because it keeps the things up.
මොකද ඒකෙන් දේවල්.
Come on, don't leave me out here alone. You know, there's a scripture for it. You shall mount up. Come on, don't leave me out here all alone. You people are leaving me here all alone now. Come on, somebody. We need to raise 3 times the offering today for what you are receiving. Somebody talk to me. You can manage Senorita here. For those watching on TV, Senorita, don't worry. Okay? It's just vanilla. Nothing happens. Senorita. But when you get older, come on, change colors. For crying out loud. Still black and white. Co-relevance. Hello, මෙතනත් ගියේ පිලවුස් එකට. තාම යන්නේ පිලවුස් එකට. Here, change.
වෙනස් කරන්න.
I'm helping you. You might be embarrassed right now, but I'm helping you. You need deliverance if you're embarrassed.
ඔබට ලැජ්ජාවක් තියෙනවා නම්, මඟට උදව් කරන්න ඔබට නිදහස් වීමක් අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා.
Same applies to the man.
ඒක පුරුෂයාට දාලායි.
When was a sarong sexy? If you're not part of our church, leave us alone. This is a young adults conference. I have a picture of Ronan in his house. Let me show it to you.
Just kidding.
All these examples I'm showing you is to show you the meaning of relevance. Not anything else. This is not a marriage counseling conference or whatever. Next month, Pastor Mel and I are having 1 day program here at the dome. It's called Secrets of the Bedchamber. It's for all married couples. We're going to have a great time talking to you about the 10 laws of the bedroom.
මේ නිදන කාමරේ න්‍යායන් 10 කියලා ලබන මාසේ එක දවසක වැඩමුළුවක් පවත්වන්නට යනවා සෑම විවාහක යුවලක් වෙනුවෙන්ම මම සහ පාස්ටර් මෙලනි එකතු වෙලා
මෙතන ඉන්න පිරිමි විතරයි අප්පුඩි ගහුවේ ආවේශ වෙලා වගේ You are part of a relevant church.
Oba adalathwe thiyena sabhawak kotas karwan.
Welcome to the glorious church.
Glorious sabhawata piligannawa.
So when are we having that conference? It's July 24th.
July mase 24 wenada.
Okay. I think it's for about 5 or 6 hours. We'll be here. Don't miss it. Don't go abroad. If you go abroad, don't come back. Number 3. As you grow in these 40 years,
ඔබ මේ අවුරුදු 40 වර්ධනය වෙන අතර
work on your perspective.
ඔබගේ ඒ අදාළ කෝණය පිළිබඳව
perspective.
ඒ තමන්ට අදාළත්වය
පිළිබඳව perspective is a powerful word.
ඒක ඉතා බලවත් වචනයක්.
You need it.
ඔබට ඒ අවශ්‍යයි.
Perspective amanta means to see things from a different angle.
ඒ කියන්නේ වෙනත් කෝණයකින් දේවල් දැකීම කියන එක.
My people, you're here. This is a problem a lot of aged people go through.
ගොඩාක් වයසට යන අයට තියෙන ප්‍රශ්නයක් මේක.
As you grow older,
ඔබ වයසට යන අතර
your perspective has to improve with every passing decade.
ඔබ එම පසු කරන දශකයක් ගානේ ඔබගේ කෝණය වෙනස් වෙන සිද්ධ වෙනවා.
Can I go deeper?
ගැඹුරට යන්නද?
You think you live a miserable life until you add perspective to it.
ඔබ ඒකට යම් කෝණයක් ගෙනෙන තාක්කල් ඔබ හිතන ඔබ දුක්ඛිත ජීවිතයක් ගත කරේ කියලා.
If I'm talking to you right now, those watching on TV, and you're thinking you're living the worst life, ever, and you have been dealt a bad hand, and God is unfair to you. What you need is perspective. The moment perspective comes in, you realize your life is very blessed. Right now, if you are sad, by one thing I tell you, and change your perspective, you'll realize how blessed you are. Right now, someone in hospital dies. Right now a mother is crying for her child. Right now a family that we know has buried their daughter who is 37 years old. And you are here. What did I just do? I changed your perspective. And now you're happy. Now you know. My people. Have you heard the term? When people get old, they're set in their ways, you can't change them?
Manushyo vayasata yana ekala kramaya hada ganna wenas karanna beri widiyata?
Ahala nadda ara kathawa hata pennat wandura halo yanne udin tamai kiyala? E kiyanne hata pennan passe minihekwa hadanna ba kiyana eka tamai kiyanne. Say it in English.
Once you pass 60, you can't change someone.
Once you pass 60, the usual norm is you can't change anybody.
Why?
Because they are set in their ways. But how come God called Moses when he was
80?
Called him when he was 80. Because the man had perspective. This is a challenge for those who are aging. Must change the way you think. Change the perspective. Can I tell you another thing to do to change your perspective? These ones are getting bold. They want. They only want señorita. Can we have a decent discussion? Here's how I change your perspective. Think of your life in the next 10 years. Don't write it. Think about it. How old will you be 10 years from today? Me, I'll be 55. The moment you think like that, you'll be not so worried about the things you're worried about now. Michaela will be 29. She'll have 3 kids by that time. In 10 years, that means I'm going to be a grandfather, dude. So, when you measure it like that, your perspective now changes. So, if some of you come and annoy me, I don't have time to get annoyed. Why? Because I have bigger things. My perspective has changed. So, as you get older, if you're going to succeed in these 40 years, you need perspective.
My God, I hope somebody
gets this. I'm only hoping at least 100 of you will get it. I don't know where the 100 are, but I'm hoping 100 will get it. As you get older, change your perspective. Change it.
Change it.
Change it. Measure what's happening around you and change it quickly.
Thank you, Lord.
Dear Jesus, some of you are still on Tarzan. Please come away from Tarzan. We are on perspective now. Number four. As you get older, in this 40-year period, focus on your assignment. Your assignment. Many people just focus on their job. But don't just do the job, focus on your assignment. What is an assignment? An assignment is the thing you were created and born to do.
Nobody
can fulfill the assignment Prophet Jerome has been given.
Prophet Jerome
Moses, lead my people into the promised land. That's your assignment.
Moses, Joshua,
divide the promised land into tribes. That's your assignment.
Joshua, porondu desha gothravalta bedala denna ekobage pavaruma.
All young adults, hear my voice.
Taruna wedi hitine mage handa ahunkan denna.
Do you know what your assignment is?
Obage pavaruma mokadda kiyala oba dannawada?
So as you move past these 40 years,
oba me avurudu 40 pahu karala yana athara,
you need to focus on your assignment.
Obage pavaruma gena oba avadane
karanna. What did Paul say in 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 7? He said, I have finished my assignment.
Paul kiwa tamange wagakima pavaruma iwara karai kiya.
Why did Jesus leave the earth at 33 and a half? He finished his assignment.
Jesus vanse avurudu 33 amaredi polaven ivattenne pavaruma iwara karapu nisa.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
That's one of the ways to live long.
Eka deerghaashu labanna eka kramayak.
When people wanted to kill Paul, Jesus visited him and said, no one can kill you until you stand before Caesar. That's my calling over your life. That tells you, as you long as you focus on your assignment, God keeps you alive.
Manushyo Paulu maranna daddi deviyanna Jesus vanse Paulta penla kiwa oba Caesar idiri hita ganna kalla oba maranna denne naha mokada eka obage wagakima pavaruma obage pavarumata oba pela gahena taakkala oba vinasa karanna kaatawat baha.
Are you focused?
Oba avadanan innawada?
Last one.
Avasana eka.
Because I think this is sufficient with your attention span.
ඔබගේ අවධාන මට්ටමත් එක්ක මේක ප්‍රමාණවත් කියලා මම හිතනවා.
Here's the last one.
මෙන්න අවසාන එක.
Maturity.
පරිණත භාවය.
You know, you don't want to be a 70-year-old baby.
ඔබ අවුරුදු 70ක බබෙක් වෙන්න කැමති නැහැ.
We have a few like that in the church.
සභාවේ ඒ වගේ කීප දෙනෙක් ඉන්නවා.
70-year-old babies. So maturity is not dependent on age. Maturity is dependent on stage and mileage.
පරිණත භාවය කියන එක වයස මත නෙවෙයි ඒක තමන් ඉන වේදිකාව සහ තමන්ගේ අත්දැකීම් මතයි.
So my sons and daughters, if you're still here,
මගේ දූ පුතුන් ඔබ තාම මෙතන ඉන්නවා නම්,
these 40 years,
මේ අවුරුදු 40
are the most important years of your life.
ඔබේ ජීවිතයේ වැදගත්ම අවුරුදු කාල පරිච්ඡේදය.
No time to waste.
නාස්ති කරන්න කාලයක් නැහැ.
Other than these five,
මේ පහට අමතරව,
yesterday you were reminded to add speed.
ඊයේ වේගය අතුල් කරන්න කියලා මතක් කරා.
Focus on your strength.
ඔබගේ ශක්තිය ගැන අවධානය යොමු
කරන්න. What is strength?
මොකද ශක්තිය කියන්නේ?
Force.
බලවේගය.
Energy level.
ඒ ශක්ති මට්ටම.
No longer should you be concerned too much about time management. You have to be concerned about energy management.
මේ කාල කළමනාකරණය ගැන වැච්චර උනන්දු වෙන්න ඕනේ නැහැ. ශක්ති කළමනාකරණය ගැන උනන්දු වෙන්න.
If you are a mother of five children,
දරුවෝ පස් දෙනෙක්ගේ අම්ම කෙනෙක් නම්,
you need more energy than a mother who has one child.
ekadaruwek inna amma kenekota wada wedi shaktiyak obata awashyai.
You get it?
Thena neda?
Energy management.
E shakti kalpana karanaya.
These 40 years are crucial.
Me avurudu 40 ita wedagat.
What else? Speed, strength and
vege shakti saha
the spirit.
Aatmaya.
I want to see you succeed.
මට ඕනේ ඔබ සාර්ථකව දකින්න.
These 40 years.
මේ අවුරුදු 40.
You might be here now.
ඔබ දැන් මෙතන ඉන්නවා වෙන්න පුළුවන්.
You might be 35.
ඔබ අවුරුදු 35 වෙන්න පුළුවන්.
You might be 45.
45 වෙන්න පුළුවන්.
You might be 56.
56 වෙන්න පුළුවන්.
Whichever wherever you are in this bracket.
ඔබ මේ කාල පරිච්ඡේදයේ කොහෙ හිටියත්.
Now you know where you're going.
දැන් ඔබ දන්න ඔබ කොහෙටද යන්නේ කියලා.
So you might still have a question and I want to answer it.
ඔබට තාම ප්‍රශ්නයක් ඇති මම ඒකට උත්තර දෙන්න ඕනේ.
Prophet, what do I do after 70?
Prophet, අවුරුදු 70 න් පස්සේ මොකද මම කරන්නේ?
You have to enjoy the fruit of all your labor.
ඔබගේ සියලු වෙහෙසේ ඵල ඔබ භුක්ති විඳින්න ඕනේ.
You didn't hear what I said.
ඔබට වුණා මං කියපු දේ.
Hello, are you here?
Another?
Can you erase this, Dimitri? Thank you. 5 more minutes, okay?
5 minutes පහක්.
Is this really helping you?
මම ඔබට උදව් වෙනව නේද?
Okay. 30
yeah.
to 70
වෙනකල් 70 වෙනකල්
which means 40 years
ඒ කියන්නේ අවුරුදු 40ක්
so question is when you reach 70
ප්‍රශ්න තමයි අවුරුදු 70ට ගියාම
what do you do
මොකද ඔබ කරන්නේ
you have to enjoy the fruit of your labor
ඔබගේ වෙහෙසේ ඵල ඔබ භුක්ති විඳින්න ඕනේ
that means
ඒ කියන්නේ
till 70
70 වෙනකල්
you can't retire
විස්රාම යන්න බෑ
If you can't retire till 70,
70 වෙනකල් විස්රාම යන්න බැයි නම්
and you have to work,
වැඩ කරන්න ඕන නම්
then you need strength.
එහෙමනම් අපිට ශක්තිය ඕනේ.
You can't go to work like this.
අපිට මේ වැඩ දෙන්න.
You can't. But the way some of you are taking care of your body, you look older than your age. Let me help you. When I was 30, that's 15 years ago, I was very indisciplined when it came to food. I thank my wife for loving me through those stages. Trust me, I was señorita. I was bad. I mean, somehow in our brains, we tell ourselves we look good. You look really good, man. Are you serious? You're deceived. When this is in front, you can't even see that. Where are you? If you're not part of our church, just relax. These are people I'm talking to. So at 30, I ended up before a Hindu doctor. No other option. Minister of God. Healing. Evangelist. Lion from Asia. Prophet of the Lord. Sitting in front of a non-Christian doctor. He asked me the first question. You look 45,
you know.
I felt ashamed. I said, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm going home and I'm changing now. How many years will it take for me to enjoy the full cycle? Thank you. 3.5 years. Some of you started a diet. Hit exercise. After 3 weeks, you lose 40 kilos and then you lose everything. Listen, don't be in a hurry to lose so much and then you get discouraged. Have a 3.5 year plan. Podda podda, if you sacrifice after 3.5 years, forget 3.5. Every 3 days you will sense, man, I'm looking better, I'm looking better. I feel better. Your confidence levels are up. This is how you need to take care of yourself. That day, that doctor woke me up. In other words, he was saying, man, you look ugly. Today, I'm 45 and I want to see him. I said, sir, do I look 30 now? Sometimes you need a wake-up call. Maybe this conference is that wake-up call. Answer the call. I said, answer the call. Answer it, make some adjustments. Changes will take place. The next 3.5 years, I see some of you prospering. I see changes happening. These 40 years of your life, some of you have got divorced. That can slow you down. Some of you experience losses. That can slow you down. But now you have a plan. Decide now. 2027.
December.
You look back. You said that conference changed my life. So start today. And enjoy the fruit of your labor. Say the fruit of my labor. Fruit of my labor. People, this doesn't mean just business. It means your kids also. There's a season after 70 where you just sit, the grandkids come and sit on your lap and you can feed them the chocolates. But now if you're not strong, which lap are they going to sit in? If your lap has arthritis. You see what I mean? Perspective. Let's make some changes
now.
God is
raising 300 powerful rock solid role
models
to follow through on what I have
taught.
Stand up to your feet.
Unboxing the Mind is the newest book written by Prophet Jerome Fernando, the best-selling author of The Money Syllabus of Jesus and You Are the Next Shining Star. This book dissects the mind into 21 components. Spanning a diverse range of subjects, it comprehensively explores every aspect and fundamental principle that underlies the intricate nature of the mind. Containing the following 10 meticulously crafted chapters, this book is designed to confront and unveil an imperceptible adversary, the mind. The mind, a noose. Where is the mind located? The mind food. The mind of God. Perception and the Holy Spirit. The discerning mind and deja vu. Visions, dreams, thoughts and meaning. Imagination, strongholds, contemplation and meditation. The black box of the mind. The mind and memory. For those aspiring to master their minds and wield complete authority over their existence, this book is an essential addition. The key to cultivate positive outcomes and conquer lives lies within this book. Visit www.timetosoar.org/mind and purchase your copy of Unboxing the Mind by Prophet Jerome Fernando now. Unbox your future as you unbox your mind.